So in this lecture, I'm going to discuss about roles and responsibilities of different people who are involved in review process. So at the end of this lecture, you should be in a position to understand who are the different people involved in review process and what are their responsibilities. So let's start with the review team. So in this particular slide, I will show you who are the different people involved in review process. And afterwards, we will discuss about each of them. So the first person who is there in the review process is the person from the management, and that is called as a manager sometimes. And he is responsible for review planning. Then comes the facilitator. So he is a person who ensures effective running of review meeting. Then comes the review leader, who takes overall responsibility for the review. Then comes the author, who creates the work product. So whichever work product which has to undergo review is created by the author. So he is a person who writes the code, or he writes the requirement or anything like that. So any document which is created by a person, then that person is called as the author. Then comes the reviewer. So he is a person who will review the document created by the author. So he is a subject matter expert. So whichever document the author is creating or whichever code he is writing, the reviewer will be the expert in that particular field. And finally comes the scribe. So he is a person who will take care of the defects, who will manage the defects. And about all these people, we will discuss now one by one. So let's start with the person from the management, like manager. So the first responsibility of manager is to plan review activity. How much time the review should take, who all will be involved. So all these things will be taken care of by the management people or by the manager. The second responsibility is the review execution. When the review will be executed, how long it will take, and how the process will be. So all those things will be taken care of by the management people. The third responsibility is to assign the budget and staff. So how many people will be involved depending upon the budget, that will be decided. Whether it will be a formal review or it will be an informal review, all these things will be decided by the management people. Coming to the last point, so the management will also monitor the review process, and if needed, they will execute the control decision in order to make review process on track. So if they feel that the review process is not on track, then they can take certain decision so that we can have an effective review process in place. So these are the four responsibilities of people from the management: planning, execution, assigning budget and staff, monitoring the review activity, and if needed, controlling the activity. So now moving from the management people to the review leader. So the review leader is normally responsible for the review activity. So overall responsible for the review. So review leader is a person who will be responsible for the review activity. And the second responsibility is the review leader will decide who will be involved in the review activity, and he will also organize the review. When the meeting will be, all those things will be taken care of by the review leader. So it has two responsibilities. First is he is overall responsible for the review, and second one is he will decide who all will be involved in the review process and who will how the review will be organized. Now next comes is the facilitator. So facilitator is a person who will be responsible for effective review meeting. How? By considering various point of view. So he will ask question to the testers, to the developer, to the reviewer, and by doing that, he is collecting different point of view, and in that way he is making the review effective. And the next point is the success of the review. So how good the facilitator is will decide how good the review will be, and that is why we say the facilitator is overall responsible for the success of the review. The next person is the reviewer. So he is a subject matter expert, as we said. So he is a person who is working on this project from a long time, or at least he has expertise on those subjects. The second thing, the reviewer will be a stakeholder. So he could be a very expert person, or he could be a stakeholder of that project also, because stakeholder also knows what they want. The third point is individual and technical knowledge. So he will have a technical knowledge and which will help him in order to review the document. And the last point is identify potential defect. So the purpose of the reviewer is, or the objective of the reviewer is, to find the potential defects or recommendations or have certain questions regarding the document. So this is the responsibility of a reviewer. And now let's move to the author. So as we said, author is a person who creates the work product which will go for the review, and the reviewer will review that. So author is a person who creates the work product. Then he is also responsible for fixing the defect in the work product, because he has created the work product, he will have a good idea about that work product. So once in the review meeting it is decided that this is a defect, then it is the responsibility of the author to fix those defects. So these are the two responsibilities of author. Now let's move to the last person, who is called as a scribe. So scribe is a person who collects potential defects found during the individual review activity. So when the reviewer will find the defect, then it's a scribe who will collect those potential defect. Okay, and the second responsibility of the scribe is to record new potential defect, open points and discussions. So during the review meeting, if what all defects are decided or discussed, or any open points are there, or any discussions are there, so scribe is a person who will collect all these informations and document it. So that is the role of scribe. So this is one of the important person in the review process. So please remember these two points, that scribe will collect the defect found during the individual review activity and records new potential defects, open points and decisions. So now, since we are done with all the people and since there are lots of information here, let's have a revision of all this topic. So if you are clear, then you can end the video here itself. Otherwise, you can continue with the revision. So we'll start with author. So author is a person who creates the work product. Then he is also responsible for fixing defect in the work product. Second is a management people. So they will do a review planning. Then they will do a review execution. Then they will assign the budget and staff. And finally, they will monitor it. And if needed, they will execute and control the decision. So this is the responsibility of management. Next comes is the facilitator. So facilitator are responsible for effective review meeting. Then they will try to bring out various point of view from different people. Finally, they will be responsible for the success of the review. Then the review leader. So overall responsibility of the review is on the review leader. And he will decide who will be involved in the review process, and he will also organize the review activity. Then comes is the reviewer. So he is a matter expert. Then he is a person who is working on that project, or at least have a expertise on that particular project. Then there could be a stakeholders who will be the reviewer. And reviewer will have an individual knowledge which will be backed up with the technical knowledge which will be helpful for him to review the product created by the author. And last person is a, or he will also identify the potential defects. So reviewer will also identify the potential defects. The last person is a scribe. So scribe is a person who will collect potential defects found during the individual review activity. And he will also record new potential defects, open points and decisions. So this is all about the summary of the roles and responsibilities of people involved in review process. So that is it from this particular slide. I will see you with my next video. Until then, happy testing.